Good morning and welcome to First Night at this Church in Newark. It's good to have you all here with us this morning, and welcome to those who are watching us online as well. Today we would like you to make sure you fill out a connection card so that we might know your needs and be able to take care of those things with you. Also, we are going to have a pizza party next Saturday from 4 to 6, and children and youth are invited to come for the lawn chair and bring your mask and be ready to have fun and see your Sunday school teachers and friends. Bring a new wrapped toothbrush to give away for the mission project also. Next Sunday at First Church, we have a business meeting for members, and it will be at 11 a.m. to noon. And it will, due to the COVID, we're doing restrictions, so both virtual and in-person opportunities have been scheduled for this church conference. So details are in the issue of Pioneer newsletter. Our family fun time will be at Van Buren Acres from 5 to 8 on October the 16th, for some fall fun. And entry for the kids is included. Youth group folks are included, and if that's paid for, adults bring are coming at their own cost. And we'll have hot dogs and s'mores and everything at 7 at the bonfire, but please respond to the office so we know how much you need to buy. Then, on the 25th, we're having a Halloween fest, and it'll be a great time in the church parking lot from 2 to 4 on Sunday. I need volunteers. So if you're able to come and help volunteer, I would love that. And we'll have a costume contest. Participants get a bag of candy, volunteers, and donations are needed. So, thank you. Coats for kids. Coats for kids and our new and gently used coats. And they're collected October the 26th through November the 9th in a box to be placed at the double glass doors in the main entrance from 9 a.m. to noon, Monday through Thursday, to collect the donations. And today is a special day. It is Worldwide Communion Day, and we will be celebrating Gracious and loving God, we thank you that you have come and given us freedom through your Son, Jesus. It is in his life and death and resurrection that we have that forgiveness of sins. And Lord, we thank you that you forgive us. And we come now before you offering our sins, that we might receive that gift of forgiveness and grace so that we might go on to give us a life that is full and rich, and also to be your witnesses into the world. Lord, we thank you that we are never alone, that you never forsake us. We thank you that you are there reaching to us even when we do make the mistakes and still calling us and saying, I love you. Let's try again. Lord, we come today lifting up all of those that need your healing strength and power. That you will come and lay your hands on them and that they will feel that and know that you are with them. Lord, we come lifting up those who have lost loved ones during this time, and may they feel your comfort and your strength. Lord, we come lifting up those first responders that are doing so many different things in so many different ways. Our police force, our folks that are doing the squads and the firefighters, and Lord, all of them, those that are working in the hospitals, we are thankful for people who can do that and be your hands and feet in that way. Whether they claim you or not, Lord, we know it's your power working through them. Lord, we come lifting up those that have gone through the rough times. And that has such a broad compass. But those that have fought illnesses, those that are fighting financial problems, those that are hungry and thirsty for righteousness as well as for just the literal food and water to drink. Lord, we come lifting up the homeless that are in our area and the homeless everywhere. And Lord, we ask that we might be agents to help. Lord, we come thanking you and praising you that we can meet together, even though it's modified, that we are still together. And we thank you that we are together in new ways and new technology. This pandemic has not been easy for anyone. And it's not been easy, Lord, for the church, but you have forced us to think beyond our normal box and to reach out. And we are going to claim, Lord, that you are making things better in ways that we've never expected. And we will hold on to the promise that you have told us. With God, all things are possible. So, Lord, help us, bless us, use us, that we will make this nation, this world, our own lives better because we are centering our lives in you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. We will continue with our praise team. And we are thankful that they will give us the song of Give Us Clean Hands.
We are going to do the baptism.
Thank you. with them and having to see them around. And we're thankful that we're able to have this opportunity, especially myself, to baptize Miss Ainsley. Hi, sweetheart. How you doing? You doing good? All right. Yeah. You looking beautiful. Just want to share with you, we pushed the baptism back just a little bit due to the fact that Caitlin and Clayton couldn't get the car started. So that's why you saw us walking all over the place, trying to push things back. And so we're glad that they're here because they drove down from Chicago for this baptism in particular as well. What a joy it is to be able to baptize your granddaughter.
Amen.
And blessing that is. And so she wants to say hi to everybody. The dress that Miss Ainsley is wearing today is one that her mommy wore, and also her aunt Caitlin wore for their baptisms. So Ainsley is saying, Tate, Grandpa, can you hurry up and let's get this one because I'm starting to get a little tired. So that's part of the book there of our word of worship here for the baptismal covenant. Let's go before the Lord at this time. Brothers and sisters, in Christ, through the sacrament of baptism, we are initiated into God's Christ Holy Church, incorporated into God's mighty acts of salvation, and given new birth through water and the Spirit. All this is God's gift, offered to us without price. I present before us all Miss Ainsley Inez baptism, Ainsley Inez Brewer for baptism. And I ask Cecilia and Robbie, on behalf of the whole church, do you renounce the spiritual forces of wickedness, reject evil powers of this world, and repent of your sin? Do you accept the freedom, power God gives you to resist evil, injustice, and oppression, whatever forms they present themselves? Do you confess Jesus Christ as your Savior, put your whole trust in His grace, and promise to serve Him as your Lord in union with the church which Christ has opened to people of all ages, nations, and races? And will you nurture Miss Ainsley in Christ's holy church, that by her teaching and example she may be guided to accept God's grace for herself and to profess her faith openly and to live a Christian life? And I ask you, as the body of the Church of Jesus Christ, will you reform both your rejection of sin and your commitment to Christ? If so, will you answer, we do.
We do.
All right. Praise be to God. I'm going to ask Miss Barb to be here as she has. Pour out your Holy Spirit, O Lord God, on this water, and as they are assembled to us, the water of life, and the receiving of the water and the Spirit, upon Ainsley this morning. In the name of Jesus Christ, we praise you for that as well. Amen. Amen. Ainsley Inez Brewer, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Gracious loving God, we give you thanks for the gift of this beautiful baby. Lord God, we pray for the continued pouring out and anointing of the Holy Spirit upon her. Lord God, watch over her, protect her, and be with her, and Robbie, and Sydney as well, and all of her life. Lord, we thank you for always being there and giving us new life through baptism. Lord God, we know that as in this hour as well, that you're with us all, and it's in the name of Jesus Christ we pray these things. Amen, amen, amen. Ladies and gentlemen, I normally walk around the sanctuary and share Miss Ainsley a little closer as we enter into this season, as we come forward in sharing with you our newest member within Christ's body in the church, Miss Ainsley Inez Brewer. Let's praise the Lord for that. I come a little closer, I'm going to say, thank you, guys. There you go, baby. You got it. this blanket was made by Betty Scott of the Comfort Quilters, and it's always a presentation that we give to the family as well. So this is for Miss Ainsley, and along with a certificate and candle that is behind us that you will receive as well at the end of the service. It is great to be able to do that. All right, go ahead and have a seat. As Miss Ainsley is ready to take over the service. I said it's always a joy to be able to share, in particular, the baptism of your granddaughter, and what a blessing that is today. Will you join me in prayer as we transition into today's message? Gracious Lord God, we give you thanks for life that you give to us all, new birth and life in this house. Lord God, we pray that the words that I speak be your words, O Lord. May we meditate on all of them today. It's in the name of our Lord and our Savior, Jesus the Christ, we pray all of these things. Amen and amen. We start this season in October, as many Methodist churches do, into the season of the Stewardship Month. And our stewardship campaign is going to be titled, Trust in the Lord. And a lot of times we see in that wording, trust in the Lord, is how important that is for us today, especially during this season. The scripture that I want to share with us that comes out of this is from Proverbs 3, 5 through 6. And it says this, trust in the Lord with all of your heart and lean not on your own understanding. In all your ways submit to him, and he will make your paths straight. That's our stewardship theme for this month, to trust in the Lord. We know that everything that we have been through this past year in 2020 with the COVID, that many of us have had to trust in the Lord in different places, in different ways, and perhaps yet even financially. And that is that stepping out, and as the scripture reminds us, it says, lean not on your own understanding.
Amen.
Lean on the Lord.
Amen.
And lean on the Lord in all that we have, in all that we do, in all that we can do. Especially as we look in our finances during this time this year, we know that financially this has hit a lot of people. And to come into a time of a stewardship campaign, I believe there's no better scripture to share with us than to trust in the Lord as our theme with everything that we have. And the scripture says also, in all your ways, submit to him and he will make your path straight. I want to share with us a video that Nick and Caleb Jones have shared with us. And they're going to share just a little bit on trusting in the Lord. Let's see that video.
We are Nick and Caleb Jones, and together with our children, Jacob and Emily, we have been attending First Church since VBS in 2013. I help out with children's ministry, I run the church website and Facebook page, and also have helped out with VBS and a few other projects.
I'm an usher and greeter on Sundays, mornings, and I also help out with the grand ministry and the men's breakfast. And we started serving at the church and said we started going here for the most of.
We believe supporting the church is important because the church supports us, not financially, but with prayers, encouragement, support, and just giving us a way to feel fulfilled in our daily.
Giving to the church is all about money. Last year we spent a few cold hours staying outside Walmart, ringing the bell for the Salvation Army. Then we had a blast handing out candy canes, and we are able to support the community with the mission. So,
one of the most important areas that we feel we can support the community is through food pantry, the coat drives, and all the serving we do. Proverbs 19:17 says, whoever is kind to the poor lends to the Lord, and he will reward them for what they have done. And for us, that doesn't just mean providing food and supplies to the less fortunate need, but also providing them some compassion and just showing them that we can be there for them while they work through these tough times. It's one of the ways that we can be the hands and feet of Christ.
Before COVID, we always burn a check and place an offering plate. With the pandemic, the way it's going right now, we can't do that. So Kayla switched to the online function of the bank, and we knew it was still needed the money, so we did it that way. And with Kayla working from home and not paying for child care or extra money to get to stuff like that, so we trust the Lord even right for us. So.
Absolutely. We want to encourage everyone to support First Church, the missions, the community support, and all the other ways. We also want to encourage people to get a little more involved in what we do at First Church and find a way that you can fill your passion as well.
I want to thank Nick and Kayla for sharing with us how during this season they've trusted in the Lord, and especially how First Church has been there for them, and how they see the return back to First Church, and also how that return not is only within First Church, but it is beyond the walls of First Church. And when we think about beyond the walls of First Church, it leads us into our scripture for this morning, for this Sunday service, is in Psalm 24, God Owns It All, is the title of this message. So I'm going to share with us the scripture out of Psalm 24 that says this: "The earth is the Lord's and everything in it, the world and all who live in it. For he founded it on the seas and established it on the waters. Who may ascend the mountain of the Lord? Who may stand in his holy place? The one who has clean hands and pure heart, who does not trust in an idol or swear by a false god. They will receive blessing from the Lord and vindication from God their Savior.
Amen.
Such is the generation of those who seek him, who seek your face, God of Jacob.
Amen.
Lift up your heads, you gates. Be lifted up, you ancient doors, that the King of glory may come in. Who is this King of glory? The Lord strong and mighty, the Lord mighty in battle. Lift up your heads, you gates. Lift them up, you ancient doors, that the King of glory may come in. Who is this King of glory? The Lord Almighty, he is the King of glory."
Amen.
May God add a blessing to his readings today. One of the things that, like many of us, stress over are finances, especially during time of this season. We stress over finances from the early stages of our life, perhaps when we first get married, and then as we move into the time of buying homes, buying cars, preparing for retirement, and living on retirement. Do I have enough financial support? When we look at a stewardship campaign, we often look at asking for that financial support within the church. Mainly to focus on our finances. And it is needed within a church, as we would know. Because the finances, that's what you give in a stewardship campaign into the church, helps to maintain the church building, helps to maintain the salaries of all the staff, helps to maintain everything within the walls, but yet not even within the walls, outside the walls of the church. The financial campaign that we look at in the stewardship campaign helps us to understand what we can do in ministry by your commitments. Many of you may have already received within the mail a financial campaign stewardship card in the mail. We received ours yesterday. I want you to take those and look at it with your family and begin to ask yourself, what can we give to the church? To pray over these campaigns and ask yourself, can we, as it says in there, step up a little bit at this time? But I also want to praise the congregation and everyone, because your financial giving has been outstanding during this season. Our financial team continues to be amazed how the church continues to give. And it is because of your giving, your continued giving during this season. It's helped us to continue to maintain all of those things within the church. But I love what Nick said in the video. And I want to go back to what Nick had said in the video as well. Nick said this, giving to the church isn't all about money. Amen to that. Giving to the church isn't all about money. Nick shared two examples of how he and Kayla and Emily gave to the church last year. It's stepping out in faith and ringing a bell for 2 hours when it is cold and helping the Salvation Army. It is taking little Emily and watching little Emily hand out candy canes to people as they're coming out. Those are signs of where we can see where people matter. It's not just within the First Church, it is in the community. And that's where I love what Nick said. Giving to the church isn't all about money. It's about giving of ourselves in different ways. You see, we can spend our whole life pursuing stuff without realizing who it belongs to.
Right.
We can spend our whole life pursuing stuff without realizing who it belongs to. When we think it's ours, we lose focus of whose it is and the purpose it's been given to us. And I believe as Nick and Caleb, as they had shared, they see that purpose. It's to continue to make disciples of Jesus Christ for the transformation of the world.
Amen.
Psalm 24, 1 and 2 says this, once again, the earth is the Lord's and everything in it, the world and all who live in it. For he founded it on the seas and established it on the waters. The earth is the Lord's.
Amen.
And everything in it. God owns it all.
Amen.
Everything. Our homes, our cars, our sanctuary, everything around us. The earth is the Lord's and everything in it. Scripture is very clear. Scripture is very clear. The earth is for the Lord, and it is for God's glory. We then, when we begin to understand that when we give financially to God, that too is for God's glory. It is for Him, and it is then that we must trust. Sometimes when we step out in faith in our giving, that's what it is. I can remember years ago when Pastor asked me about starting to tithe. I thought, how can I do that? How can I give 1/10 of my salary to the church? It's trusting in the Lord. I'll talk about that a little bit more in a couple of weeks when we talk about tithes and offerings to God as well. You see, when we begin to trust, it's understanding, as Jesus said in Matthew, he said this, seek first his kingdom. Seek first his righteousness. And all these things will be given unto you. We are seeking Him first. We are to be trusted. Trusting Him with everything. If we understand who it belongs to, it will help us understand a better biblical perspective of our resources. Let me say that again. If we understand who it belongs to, it will help us understand a better biblical perspective of our resources. Because we will be able to see where all of our resources actually come from. All the blessings that we have. One of the things I love about the psalm that we had shared is it's actually, back when it was written, it would be a hymn that was sung. A hymn when the congregation would come in and they would sing Psalm 24 and praise to God for all the blessings that God had given to them. And then they would recognize that all things had been founded by God, given to us. And the praise that they would continue to sing in there is that they would say, give us clean hands. Give us pure hearts. Give us this, Lord God, as we enter into your house, as we enter into this place. Because we're not to trust in an idol or swear by a false god. It is recognized that all is given to us. And I love what it says in verse 5. When we begin to understand all of this that is given to us, in verse 5 it says this, they will receive blessing from the Lord and vindication from God their Savior. A blessing will come to us when we be able to see what God has given to us today. Caleb, I love what Caleb had said in the video as well. Caleb said this. She said, God does not often let me out of Sam's Club to purchase food for the food pantry. She said, I am thankful God provides the finances to do that, to be the hands and feet of Christ. Caleb didn't understand that. God provides the finances. The finances have come to them from God to be able to be the hands and feet of Christ. To be able to have God's Spirit reach upon you to say, you're not getting out of Sam's Club just yet. I want you to get some food for the food pantry because that helps people in need. That's where people matter in life, is helping them in need. How does God shake us up a little bit? How does God begin to understand in our life what it is all about giving back? A stewardship campaign is about the presentation of ourselves to God and giving back to God for what God has given to us. When we look at the word steward, we are the ones to be in charge and keep of everything. God wants us to be good stewards with all that He has given to us today. So where does this put us during this campaign? During this stewardship campaign, how do we see things? Do you see things in the earthly eyes? Or do you see things in a godly eye? And see things how God sees things. Because when we begin to, as Kayla and Nick had shared, when we begin to put on those godly vision, godly eyes, we begin to see things differently. We can ask ourselves this question. Why did God place me here? What is my purpose in life? What can I do to make a difference in the world? What can you do to make a difference in the world? Can you ring a bell for 2 hours? Can you hand out candy canes like a 4-year-old does and say, Jesus loves you? Can you give of yourself when you give into the world to make a difference? That's a part of the stewardship campaign, is understanding that God owns it all. God owns it all. And we will begin to see the benefits when we give back and how we give back. Jesus in Matthew 26, we may be familiar as He begins to share with them perspective of the individuals gathered together, of what it may look like in the future. When Jesus said, did you see me when I was hungry? Did you feed me? Did you visit me? Have we done those things to reach out to the people? Because God is depending on you. God is depending on you to continue to do the ministries, not just here at First Church, across the world. Because we are the vessels of light out in the world. We are the vessels of Jesus Christ that can make a difference. We are those that can get out and be involved. As Caleb had said, God provides the finances to be the hands and feet of Christ. And I love in particular in the very end of what Caleb said. Caleb said, get involved. Get involved. I want to encourage you to find that place where you can get involved. There are many places where we can get involved in the church to be the hands and feet of Christ. One of the easiest ways, I think, is to give. To give to the church. But I truly believe God is putting a charge on each and one of us to do more than that. To get involved, to be the hands and feet of Christ. And to see and understand that God wants to know. And it is for God's glory. We join you in prayer. Gracious, loving God, we give you thanks for always and always being there for us. providing, given to us every day of our life. Give us new eyes, Lord God, to see things differently. Give us a clean hands and a pure heart, Lord God, to be the vessels of reaching out to those in need. And Lord, as we gather together in the celebration and the remembrance of the sacraments that were given to us, instituted by our Savior Jesus Christ through the power of the Holy Spirit today, the sacraments of the bread and the juice remind us of the body broken and the blood poured out for the forgiveness of our sins. Lord, may we start today in recognizing your love and grace and mercy for each and every one of us and those that are hungry out in the world. Not only hungry for a piece of bread, but hungry for your Spirit to be placed upon them as well. And it's in the name of Jesus, our Savior, we pray these things. Amen. We're going to prepare ourselves as we gather together in Holy Communion. And many of you have already received a cup for our service as well. If you've not received a small cup, I don't know, maybe our ushers in the back can help you out. Did everyone receive their cup at home here in the sanctuary? And I want to encourage us at home to have your elements ready as well, with the bread and the juice as well as we gather together. We join us together, Pastor Barb and myself, as we prepare the elements. Join along with us. Christ our Lord invites to his table all who love him, who earnestly repent of their sin, and seek to live in peace with one another. Therefore, let us confess our sin before God and one another. Merciful God, we confess that we have not loved you with our whole hearts. We have failed to be an obedient church. We have not done your will. We have broken your law. We have rebelled against your love. We have not loved our neighbors, and we have not heard the cry of the needy. Forgive us, we pray. Free us for joyful obedience through Jesus Christ our Lord. Hear the good news. Christ died for us while we were yet sinners. That proves God's love towards us. In the name of Jesus Christ, you are forgiven.
In the name of Jesus Christ, you are forgiven.
Glory be to God.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right and a good and joyful thing always and everywhere to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and of earth. You formed us in your image and breathed into us the breath of life. When we turned away, our love failed, and your love remained steadfast. You delivered us from captivity, made covenant to be our sovereign God, and spoke to us through your prophets. Who look for the day when justice shall roll down like waters and righteousness like an ever-flowing stream. When nation shall not lift up sword against nation, neither shall they learn war anymore. And so with the people on earth and all the company of heaven, we praise your name and join in their unending hymn. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory.
Hosanna.
Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord.
Hosanna
in the highest.
Holy are you, and blessed is your Son, Jesus Christ. Your Spirit anointed him to preach good news to the poor, to proclaim release to the captives, and recovering of the sight to the blind, to set at liberty those who are oppressed, and to announce the time come when you would save your people. He healed the sick, fed the hungry, and ate with the sinners. By the baptism of his suffering, death, and resurrection, you gave birth to your church, delivered us from slavery to sin and death, and made us a new covenant by water and the Spirit. At his ascension, you exalted him to sit and reign with you at your right hand. which he gave himself up for us, he took the bread, he gave thanks to you, he broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples and said, take, eat, this is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me.
When the supper was over, he took the cup, gave thanks to you, gave it to his disciples and said, drink from this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, poured out for you and for many, and for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. And so in remembrance of these, your mighty acts in Jesus Christ, we offer ourselves in praise and thanksgiving as a holy and living sacrifice in union with Christ's offering for us as we proclaim the mystery of faith.
Christ is alive, Christ is risen, Christ will come again.
Amen. Amen. Pour out your Holy Spirit on us, gather here and on these gifts of bread and wine. Make them be for us the body and blood of Christ, that we may be for the world the body of Christ, redeemed by his blood. By your Spirit, make us one with Christ, one with each other, and one in ministry to all the world, until Christ comes in final victory and we feast at his heavenly banquet. Through your Son, Jesus Christ, with your Holy Spirit and your Holy Church, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. Amen. And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, let us pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. And forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Amen.
I want to encourage each and every one of us as we take the bread that is joined together, and as we tear off the top portion, share together the body of Christ broken for you. Take it and eat. Likewise, in the same manner, the juice, the blood of Christ given to us, take and drink, and do this in remembrance of him. Join me in prayer. Gracious Lord God, we give you thanks and praise for the victory that we have from Savior Jesus Christ. It is by the broken nature of Jesus Christ that we are restored together as the body. Glory God, through this giving of this bread and this juice, may they ever serve as the reminder of the grace and love that you give to us through our Savior Jesus Christ in his body and blood that was poured out on Calvary. Give you thanks and praise for the gift of God today. And it's in his name we pray all of these things. Amen. Amen. Praise be to God. Let us join together within our hearts in our closing praise song.
Revelation song.
There you go. Revelation song.
Thank you.
love God, we give you all praise, honor, and glory, because you are the King of Kings, and all the glory goes to you. For all the blessings you do give to us every day, the blessings that we fail to see, Lord God, we want to continue to give you praise for that. We want to thank you, God, for being here with us in this hour of worship, the opportunity to be in this place, where it may be in our homes or in the sanctuary, Lord God. It is always a true blessing. Always a true blessing to be with you, to worship you, God, every day of our life. And Lord God, as we depart from this house, Lord God, let us not forget that all things given to us are created beautifully for us, Lord God. You give to us in abundance. And you give us, Lord God, today a new opportunity to worship you, to praise you, to thank you. We do that today. May we go knowing in the peace and confidence of our Savior Jesus Christ that He's with us now and always. Amen.